New York Attorney General is now announcing that the Trump Foundation has agreed to dissolve under judicial supervision. But that move, considered a small legal victory for the prosecutors, will not end the state's lawsuit against the embattled charity. CNN's Erica Orden joins us now. This does appear to be a victory nonetheless for the AG's office in New York, Erica.
It does. The Trump Foundation had previously said it wanted to dissolve, but this will mean that the charity dissolves in a manner that the AG's office was seeking, under judicial supervision, as you mentioned, and with the Attorney General's office able to review the recipients of the charity's assets. It currently has about $1.7 million in assets, according to its most recent tax filing.
And what is the significance of this as we look at the big picture here, Erica? What exactly does this mean as it pertains to the Russia investigation?
Well, it's not clear that it has a direct link to the Russia investigation, but it is one of the now numerous investigations that Trump and people in his orbit find themselves under. The lawsuit alleges, among other things, unlawful coordination between the charity and the president's political campaign or presidential campaign. And the lawsuit, as you mentioned, will move forward in court because it also seeks two additional outcomes. One, about $2.8 million in restitution plus penalties, and it also seeks to ban the president and his three eldest children from serving on the boards of other New York nonprofits.
Okay, Erica Orden, thank you for bringing us the latest there. I want to bring in my colleague, Shimon Procupes. This news coming, Shimon, as we are awaiting the sentencing of the president's former national security advisor, Michael Flynn. Now we're learning the Trump Foundation has agreed to dissolve in this lawsuit. The president is likely watching all of this play out. This is not good news for him.
No, it's really not. And let me just quickly read the statement that the attorney general there put out in response to this. She said, our petition detailed, these are the court records, detailed a shocking pattern of illegality involving the Trump Foundation, including unlawful coordination with the Trump presidential campaign, repeated and willful self-dealing, and much more. This amounted to the Trump Foundation functioning as little more than a checkbook to serve Mr. Trump's business and political interests. I mean, that are some tough words from the Attorney General. It's clear that the Trump Foundation and the president and his family wanted this to go away. They found a resolution. You know, you have to wonder, look, we've heard other issues, obviously, out of the Southern District of New York, which has been investigating campaign finance. So is this going to go away? Perhaps, but it may not end the other liabilities that could potentially affect the Trump organization. That still seems to be in the crosshairs of investigators. So certainly you're right, Pam. This is not good for Trump, for the president. There's a lot going on.
And there are 17 investigations that have arisen from the Trump Russia investigation. This is one of them. This is according to a article written by Garrett Graff on Wired. And so it just goes to show, while the president is calling this probe a witch hunt, you're seeing outcomes like this, that now his foundation is dissolving. That was a strong rebuke from the Attorney General's office, Michael Zeldin. I want to bring you in on this, saying that this was a case of self-dealing as it pertains to the foundation. Making the claim that they were using the foundation as a personal checkbook. What do you make of this? What is the significance?
So the language that this was a pattern of illegal self-dealing is the same pattern that we're seeing in the charges with respect to the inaugural committee for domestic donors, for the inaugural committee for foreign donors, for the emoluments lawsuit of self-dealing. So we have a lot of cases against Trump and his organization and his family that allege self-dealing. And so I think the story here is that this is the first time that a government agency has essentially obtained the admission of the Trump organization that it was indeed self-dealing. And now we're going to have to see how these self-dealing allegations play out in these other lawsuits, because it's the exact same pattern, Pamela, that we're seeing. And that's what's so troubling to so many people.